The 7th Panzer Division, yeah, man. We know that, of course, because of the Y insignia. Today, we'll see more unreleased footage of the Ghost Division in the early days of Barbarossa and talk about some of the decisions made with the taking of the Lithuanian capital Vilnius. Then, we'll see how the division moved to the southeast and took the important rail station at Molodoczno, near Minsk, which would become an important resupply hub for the Germans. Finally, I'll present a Russian close combat training film that was used by the Wehrmacht to give young recruits a feeling of what they were likely to experience in the East. For raw and unreleased World War II footage, this is the best channel on YouTube, and I like that. The advance towards Vilnius went quickly, encountering limited resistance. Approaching the large city, the divisional commander, Funk, decided against sending armored formations into a situation that could easily develop into urban street fighting. He swung the majority of the division out around the eastern side of the city and sent the fast-moving armored cars and motorcycle battalions in to take the city. This footage is from Deutsche Wochenschau number 565 from the 4th of July, 1941. In this campaign map from June 24th, we see that the Ghost Division was situated to the northeast, having reached the river Vilnia and securing the system of roads which led southeast towards Minsk. Although not wanting to enter the city with his armor, Funk believed that moving it into the immediate outskirts would intimidate the Soviets and keep them from putting up a staunch defense. At 6:15 in the morning, lead elements were able to take control of Vilnius South Airport, capturing 25 undamaged Soviet planes. The majority of the day was spent mopping up pockets of Soviet resistance, and responsibility of the city was eventually handed over to the 20th Motorized Infantry Division. Take a look at the great videos we've produced on that unit. This is footage of the river Vilnia, which is 84 kilometers long and flows through the eastern part of the city, which is an industrial region. It's a tributary of the river Neres. I got a question that was related to old film deterioration and digitization. There certainly is an issue with old film deteriorating, which at some point becomes useless. Damaged film is often brittle, it can shrink, and it can have an acidic vinegar smell. If film is in reasonable condition, a transfer to digital is done by playing it in a mirrored box and re-recording it directly. For a better result, individual frames can also be photographed and then, with special software, re-timed together. This process is both time-consuming and expensive, but won't damage the film and the results can be better. This is a campaign map from the following day, June 25th, 1941. The 7th advanced southeast along the highway in parallel with the 20th Panzer Division. Leaving their left flank vulnerable to attack in exchange for speed of movement had been a calculated risk. The enemy's positioning in that sector was unknown, and so marked on the map with the question, "Feind frei," which means free of enemy. The risk had paid off, and by the afternoon, the important rail hub at Molodoczno was taken. This is splendid footage of the station at Molodoczno after it was put back into service by the Germans. Using the rail system was challenging for various reasons. Much of it was destroyed by the Russians when they retreated. The gauge of the tracks and trains were different than what was used in Western Europe. And finally, the hub and spoke system spread out from east to west, which was the opposite of what the Germans needed. Here we see the unloading of heavy 1,000 kilogram Hermann bombs. The typical German Heinkel HE-111 bomber could carry two of these. There was also a monster-sized 1,800 kilogram bomb that the Germans nicknamed Satan. This 1939 Russian bayonet training film has a runtime of 28 minutes and 39 seconds. Quickly, the Germans realized that the Russian soldier on an individual level, especially in close combat, was an enemy not to be taken for granted. To give young recruits an idea of what they were likely to experience in the East, the Wehrmacht trainers showed them this film. If you'd like me to upload the entire training film, please let me know in the comment section below. However, the enemy will certainly defend himself. The Soviet trainers teach the soldiers to counter each enemy thrust with either a bayonet thrust of their own or striking with the butt of their rifle. It's not enough to only deflect the enemy's thrust. Thank you for watching.